This Vaishnava song gives the essence of human form of the life. Everybody know the meaning? You want me to explain? I'll take some. Bhajavare mana Sri Nandanandana. Nandanandan Sri Krishna. And he is also Abhay Charanaravinda. He is the one who makes us fearless. Why we are fear of? What is the cause of our fear? Attachment. Where there is attachment, fear automatically comes. We are afraid to lose that thing. So when there is no attachment, no fear. So attachment always there. So somebody should try how to get out this attachment. Yukta Vairagya, not that, oh, I leave everything and go, no. So one should have the Yukta Vairagya. Bhakti means Vairagya. Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janayati As Vairagyam Jnanam Payadahitukim. When you perform the devotional service to Vasudeva Sri Krishna, automatical detachment for the material enjoyment and the transcendental knowledge automatically come. So it is see how much is attached to the material possessions, that is seen how much we are advancing the bhakti. Bhakti pareshan bhava virakti anitra chaisa trishayika kala. It is also said it. So to become free from this material world, one should take shelter of Abhay Charan, Nandanandan Sri Krishna. Durlabha manava janam satsange. This human form of the life is very, very difficult to get it. Even the demigods also want to have this human body. They are not happy in the heavenly planet. Read that 5th canto, 19th chapter, where the glorification of the Jambudvipa is mentioned. The demigods say, how unfortunate we are in the heavenly planet. How fortunate these people on the earth planet. They are performing devotional service to the Supreme Lord Hari. And they can go back to Vaikuntha. We are not. They curse themselves. The first day I repeated that what they say. Two verses wonderfully mentioned it. The final they said, Nayatra Vaikuntha Katha Sudhapaga Nasadavu Bhagavata Dasraya Nayatra Yagnishumakha Mahotsava Surendra Loko Pinavaisa Sevyatam. Suresh Loka means the abode of Indra, which got all opulences. In upper plant system, Indra Loka, where King of Heaven stays, that got all opulences, unlimited. For the duration you stay, you get unlimited opulences. Say that in the place where there is no facility to hear the pastimes of Katha Sudha Paga. The pastimes of the Lord, compared to the nectar, superior to the nectar. In the beginning of the glorification of Bhagavata mentioned that Sudha, nectar, it can only give the languity in the life. But it cannot provide the liberation from this life. But however, the Bhavat Katha is compared to the nectar, where there is no provision, no facility to hear the pastimes of the Supreme Lord Katha, or they know the devotees who coming and going, devotees. The devotees coming to any place mean they speak Krishna Katha and they glorify Krishna, do the Harinam Sankirtan, and they know Yajna, Harinam Sankirtan Yajna, Nayatra Yajnesha Makhamaha Utsava, Utsava, there is no facility. Here we celebrate Janmashtami, Krishnashtami, Ramanami, Balarama Pirende, Radhashtami. In upper planet there is no celebration. Even Vaikuntha there is no celebration. Why? Krishna doesn't appear, he is not taken birth there. Eternally there. Radharani eternal there. Here they appear, so we celebrate here. Of course, they celebrate every day the festival in different mood, but our celebration is a different mood. Balaram eternally there, Radharani eternally there. So how can you say, today you took your birthday? But that is possible earth planet. They say that those celebrations, Mahotsavas, are not there. If that place be abode of King Indra, reject it. Na sevyatam. Durlabha manavi janam sasya. This human body, I said 2 days before, it is a karma bhumi. What we do in this human body, we get it. To enjoy the result of this activity done this human body, the upper plant system, lower plant system. Out of the 14 plant system, 13 are there to enjoy the results of what we do in this human body. If you do the sinful activity, one can go to hell easily. If we do pious activity, we can easily go to heaven, upper plant system. If I do the bhakti, devotion service, fully surrender, I can go to Vaikuntha, liberation, Golok Vrindavan. That is possible only in this human body. Except Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, no one can go to the abode of the Lord. Everyone has to take birth as human being, perform Hari Bhakti and go. There is no other way. That is word of Lord Sri Krishna in 11th canto. Sarginopetam icchanti lokam niranyastada sadhakam jnana bhakti bhyam ubhayam tat asadhakam. These two, getting transcendental knowledge and bhakti, not possible in the heaven or hell. That is Lord Krishna says. So this is Durlabha, means after passing through the 8.4 million spaces of life, Lord Krishna, out of causeless mercy, give that living entity, jiva, this human body. Oh, this living entity suffered, undergone lot of suffering. Let me give this human body so that it can perform devotion service to me and come back to me. He wants to take every living entity back to home, but living entity, we don't want to go. Everybody know what is the 8.4 million spaces of life details? Those who do not know, just you can hear it. 900,000 varieties of aquatics, 1.1 million varieties of the insects and reptiles, and 3 million varieties of the four-legged animals, 2 million varieties of plant, trees and creepers, 1 million varieties of the birds, 400,000 varieties of human beings. Starting from Mahabrahma to lower plant system, all these human beings, so that is 8.4 million. That's a Durlabha Manava Janam Satsanga. And not only this one, satsang, taking association of the devotee, is also not easy. Very fortunate people get it. And Padma Puran nicely mentioned, Bhakti Devi speaking to Narada Maharshi, she says, Bhagyodayena Bahujanma Samarjitena Satsangamam Chalabhate Purusho Yadavai Ajnana Hetu Krutamuha Madhandaka Nasham Vidhaya Tato Deyi Vivika. Bhagyodayena Bahujanma means when one performs the pious activities for many, many lifetimes, not 1, 2, 3, Bahu, plural. Then the end result of that pious activity, that you will come in contact with a devotee, sadhu. That association with the devotee is satsang. And when you meet a devotee speak about Krishna and tell you to speak, Prabhu, chant Hare Krishna, come to Sunday, have prasadam, take darshan of the Lord. Because of that one, what happens? Ajnana hetu krita moha madhandakara. In the previous life, due to ignorance, he might have committed many, many sinful or pious activity, which we have to undergo the birth and death. So because we have taken the association of the devotees, we heard the pastimes of the Lord, the reaction of all the sinful activities will be nullified, and the wisdom will be awakened in that. It means when we get the wisdom, then we don't commit sinful activity. Oh, now it is, I must take shelter of Krishna. I must take shelter of pure devotee and chant Hare Krishna, become a devotee. I don't want to take birth again. That is the Bahujanma. Sita Atapa Bhata Varisana. In the winter and summer, in the rain and on the wind, I've been suffering. Why? just to maintain my family. I have to work hard to maintain the family. And maintaining the family, what I get? I get a little happiness. Lava sukha. Lava means a very, very fraction. For the little happiness, I have to work so hard. In the Bhagavatam, it is mentioned the family members are the timingal, whales, crocodiles. You can see in the family life, the head of the family may work from the whole till the last moment of the life. Nobody says, oh, father, you work very hard. Now you take rest. I will work. Does anybody say? Till the last moment of the life, still you are working, nobody is happy. That is the nature of the life. Chapalasukha lavala agri. For the little happiness, I have to work so hard. Edhana yavana putra parijana. Don't be proud of your richness. How long it will remain? Only you leave the body, rich goes back. Richness is not permanent. Don't be proud of your strength. Oh, I got strength, I can he-man. But when you become 50 years, no he-man. When you are young, you can got lot of strength. When you become 50 or 60 years old, you can't recognize your own photo. Oh, who is this guy? Because these all are subject to the time. And because of their subject to time, they diminish. Everything in the material world is subject to the time. You may construct a good, very powerful, nice building, strong, concrete, cement. But after 300 years or 400 years, you think it is so strong again still? We see so many buildings. Because everything is subject to time. So that because of that, they will lose the strength, they will one day vanish. Same Shankaracharya also wonderfully mentions in the final instruction to his disciples. All instructions are, anybody understand those instructions will get detached. Makuru dhana jana yauvana garvam harati nimesha kala sarvam maya mayamidam akhilam buddhva brahma padatvam pravisha viditva. Don't be proud of your richness. Don't think that I got so many followers. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim kavitam va. All acharyas say the same, they are no different. Because these are temporary, everything is subject to the time. So, brahma padatvam pravisha. You are the Brahman. You are the part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. Brahma, you are Brahman. So, always think of the Brahma, not this material thing. All acharyas say. Finally, kamala dala jala jivana talamal. This life is just like very unstable. Just like if you take a water, leaf of a lotus flower, put a drop of water, and little vibration will fall down. At the same time, the water is not attached to the leaf. You can take the lotus leaf, a lotus flower, though it sustains in the water only, but you don't see a single drop of water on it. So our family life should be like that one. Staying with a family, don't get attached. Yes, my duty, the children are property of Krishna, I'm just a custodian. To raise the children, give education, teach them is my responsibility. After that, when they grow up, okay, they are on way. Because they enjoy or suffer according to the karma, what they did in previous life. I did my responsibility to bring them up. Now my time is, I want to take shelter of Krishna. Both the dharmas you have to follow. Loka dharma is the body, dharma related to the body, society, it goes for certain. But atma dharma must continue for end of the life. The dharma performed for the pleasure of the atma and Supreme Lord is the only one which goes with us. Other dharma stays back. Did anybody saw when husband dies, has seen any wife also dying, children dying, bank balance going with him, car, TV go? Nothing. So these all are related to the body, so they stay with the body, even to the extent the body, which we take care of so much, it stays back here. Soul leaves the body. So for that, what we have to do? Govinda Das Kavira said that Sravana Kirtan Navada Bhakti, Sravana Kirtan Smarana Vandana Pada Sevana Dachare. By performing all the nine or one of them, each one of them is capable of taking us back to Godhead. La Prabhupada in the way in the seventh canto, in the Prahlad Maharaj's pastimes, for this one, elaborate explanation has given. Srila Prabhupada writes that each and every limb of this devotional service, if you hear it, all the time hear, perfectly apply to your life, one can be get liberation. If you are just glorifying, keep on glorifying. Each and every limb of this devotional service is capable of taking us back to Krishna. That is Govinda Kaviraj says. Govinda Kaviraj ki jai, Jashla Prapad ki jai. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Chachurni Litam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangham Langhayate Girim Yatkrupatamaham Vande Sri Gurum Dinataranam Paramananda Madhavam Sri Chaitanya Mesharam Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Pitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Yutapada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamcha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakanitam Cha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarsati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pachacha Deshatarni Panchatattvatmakam Krishnam Bhakti Rupa Sarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktakyam Namami Bhakta Shaktikam He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gorangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Suti Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Kasturi Tilakam Lalata Patale Vakshastale Kostubam Nasagre Varamauktikam Karatale Venum Kare Kankanam Sarvangi Harichandanam Sulilitam Kanthe Chamuktavali Gopastri Pariveshtito Vijayate Gopala Chudamani Jeyam Sada Paribhavagna Abhishtadoham Tethasvadam Shiva Viranchunutam Sharanyam Vrityardham Pranatapala Bhavabdipotam Vande Mahapurushate Charanarabindam Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripasindhubhyevacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna to all the devotees of the Lord. We continue from yesterday's. Yesterday we did, we speak about up to the performing puja, worship of the Govardhan. Then they all did parikrama to Govardhan. And what is very nicely mentioned that everybody should be, everybody was well decorated with ornaments and good clothes. So when we also go for parikrama, normally they would say, oh, we are going parikrama, all the dust will come, let me put the old clothes. Many people, you can see, many devotees, because sometimes we have to sit on the floor. So it is not, Lord Krishna, that's swalankrita. Everybody should be properly dressed. If you are properly dressed, we don't know what time Krishna will be we will get attracted by Krishna, we don't know. Especially Mataji, when they go for service, get attracted, nicely dress it so that maybe you will be attracted by Krishna. You will be fortunate. So when we are attracted by Krishna, yes, our life becomes hard. We are attracted by somebody else, life becomes difficult. So one should be well decorated with all ornaments it is. Krishna specifically mentioned that point. Okay. So after that, they all went to for the parikrama. Yesterday we did manasik, mentally parikrama. Just we couple of minutes we spend it, then we continue the story. Just I repeat different places. When you do parikrama, many places come across. So when you go parikrama, you will say, oh, we are talking about that. Just we say Radhe Radhe. Kusum Sarovar ki Radhe Radhe. Okay. Kusum Sarovar Radhe Narada Kunda Radhe Rasasthali Radhe De Manasi Ganga Chiklish Mahadev Mukharavinda Brahmakunda Nanaghati Papamachan Kunda Anyurgaon Sankarshan Kunda Govinda Kunda Navala Kunda Apsara Kunda Punchari Lota Baba Indra Kunda Jatipura Gulal Kun Uddhav Kun Garadha Kun Shama Kun. So it means when you are going, these are the main, but there are 72 places all around. And we don't get that time. Those who go, do the parikrama 2-3 days, they can go all up. But if you want to do one day, 5-6 hours, so few places we can see. In this Pochirwala Lota Baba, we said it, when Lord Krishna left Vraj to Mathura, he asked, hey, all his friends asked, when are you going to come back? I will just come back, as if he's going to come back next day. So that Pochirwala, his cowherd boy, is still waiting for Krishna to come, when he is going to come. So devotees, when you go on parikrama, there will be pure essences. There from Jatipura we take a turn for Govinda Kund, that side. So that temple, all devotees pay obeisances and keep that place on right hand. When you are doing parikrama, you must all ensure that the Vrindavan, if you are doing Vrindavan parikrama, Vrindavan should be on right hand. If you are doing Govardhan parikrama, should be always in the right hand, not on the left hand, it's in auspicious. Okay. So having gone here, that today we'll discuss from the 25th chapter. What is the verse written? 13. Okay. Repeat it. Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Davannatham Gokulam Prabhu.
Davannatham Gokulam Prabhu.
Tratumarasi
Devanaha.
Kupitad Bhakta Vachala. Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Tannatham Gokulam Prabhu. Tratumarasi
Devanaha.
Kupitad Bhakta Vachala. Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga. Tannatham Gokulam Prabhu. Ratumarasi
Devanna
Kupidad Bhakta Vachala.
Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga.
Tannatham Gokulam Prabhu.
Ratumarasi
Devanna
Kupidad Bhakta Vachala. Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga. Tannatham Gokulam Prabhu. Ratumarasi
Devanna
Kupitad Bhakta Vatsala. Mataji.
Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga Uttanatam Gokulam Prabhu Tatumarasi Devana Kupita Bhakta Vachala Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga Vannatham Gokulam Prabhu Kratumarasi Devana Kupita Bhakta Vachala.
Translation purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. The cowherd men and women addressed the Lord Krishna, Krishna Krishna, O most fortunate one, please deliver the cows from the wrath of Indra. O Lord, you are so affectionate to your devotees, please save us also. Purport. At the time of Lord Krishna's birth, Gargamuni had predicted, Anena Sarva Durgani Yuyam Anjastariyastha. By His grace, you will easily cross beyond all difficulties. The residents of Vrindavana were confident that in such a great emergency, Lord Sri Narayan would empower Krishna to protect them. They accepted Krishna as everything and Krishna reciprocated their love. So when they performed the Govardhan Puja, yesterday we were discussing, on the Pratipada, next day after the Diwali. And the second day, first day after Diwali is the Govardhan Puja, second day they celebrate Bhai Dooja. It's another festival in North India. Bhai Dooja. Bhai. 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 Brother. So they celebrate it. They celebrated. So on second day, Indra was inquiring, what happened? Deepavali gone, Pratipada's first day gone, and today second day is also going out, and nobody, what happened to the offerings for me? Nobody sent my offerings. I am not receiving any offerings of the fire sacrifice which they used to do every year. He inquired when the messengers came back and told that, my dear Lord, they know more glorification of your name. All Vrajavasis are glorifying Krishna, Krishna only. They didn't perform yajna for you, but they performed yajna for Govardhan. And Indra became very, like a fireball, became very, very angry.
Indrastadatmana pujam vijnaya vihitam rupa gopebhya krishna tebhyo nanda bichakho gopaha.
Became very angry. When he heard that, they're hearing from Krishna, they did yajna for the Govardhan on the advice of Krishna. He became very angry with the Nanda Baba and all the Gokul people. Then immediately he wanted to give a lesson to them.
Aho simada mahatyam gopanam kanakno kasam krishnam martyam upasitya e chakrur deva helanam.
Aho, alas, these gopa gopis, the residents of the Vrindavan, the Gokul, they become proud of their opulences. I am giving the rains every year. So with the rain, they become very rich. They get the grains and they get the good cows also. They sell the milk. They become rich. Because of the rich, they become very proud of their opulences.
Srimad Mahatma. Mad means ego. Gopanam kanaganogasam. People stay in the forest. Krishna Marchumuvasista. They took shelter of a mortal who is Krishna. He is calling Krishna as a mortal. And they insulted, humiliated the Deva Helanam. They ignored the demigods.
So when he understood that, Indra, having thought this one, he called the, he wanted to give some
lesson to the Brajavasis. Yathadrulay karmamai katabhirna mani nainabhi vijjhamanvavichi vichakki anvichikam hitvatitishanti bhavarnavam. They're taking shelter of Krishna is just like a foolish attempt of men who abandon the transcendental knowledge and of the self real of the self, and instead they cross, take to the material karmakanda to cross over this bhavanam material world. Means they ignore the transcendental knowledge, they accept to the material activities so that they can cross this birth and death cycle. Bhava means birth and death. Arnava means ocean. This both material world is called samsara sagar. Bhava sagar. Bhava means birth and death, sagar means ocean. Just like when we stand on the bank of ocean, we cannot see other side of the ocean, bank of the ocean. In the same way, we don't know when our this cycle of birth and death started in this material world and when we are going to finish, we don't know. That's why the material world is compared to the bhavanavam, like ocean. It is called samsara because it is always moving. Samsarati is samsara. Because the material world is subject to the time, it is not steady, always moving, never is steady. So, these people have taken the material activity, ignoring the spiritual transcendent knowledge to cross this. It is just giving example that these people ignoring me, the demigods, and me, king of heaven, and they have taken shelter of a mortal, Krishna. And what type of Krishna is? Wonderfully using. Vachalam balisham stabdham ajnam panditamaninam krishnam martyam upasritya gopami chakrapriya. Krishna is vachalam, too much talkative. We say, no, you talk too much. He is a child, balisham. Child we call is stupid. Child he doesn't know. Stabdham, very arrogant. Ajnam, ignorance, you don't know. Child don't know, see. A person in the ignorance, he can talk anything. Ajnam is doesn't know anything. Pandita maninam. Maninam means he thinks of himself as a man of knowledge, expert. Krishna martyam upasritya. Without Krishna, he is a human being, mortal. And these gopas taken shelter of such a mortal person and they made me apriyam, they made disappointed me, the demigods. So, Sridhar Swami, though Indra using this word against Krishna to humiliate him, but Sridhar Swami, being a pure devotee, used the same words in glorification of Krishna. Vachalam, Acharya excellent, Vachalam means, alam means abode. And all the knowledge is abode of all the knowledge. There is no one else who knows more than Krishna, is it? So is the Vachalam, yes, is what he is saying also correct. Balisham, childhood. Child is innocent. After 4 or 5 years, child started become little partiality. But in the childhood, 1 year, 2 years, they are very, very innocent, pure. So, the Supreme Lord also impartial to anyone. He doesn't have any partiality with anyone. So, that's why he is a balisham, sabdham, very arrogant for the negative. But here, Sridhar Swami says that is sabdham because there is no one superior to Krishna. As such, he doesn't have to pay obeisance or accept orders from anyone. The same behavior, material world, become arrogant. Hey, how arrogant he is. Doesn't listen to me. But in case of Krishna, Sridhar Swami says that there is no one superior to him. Why should you accept anybody other authority? Ajnam. In negative, is using Indra using this word, ajnam means is ignorance. But he says that he knows all the knowledge. There is no knowledge which he doesn't know. Pandita, he is a man of all the full knowledge, is fully expert knowledge. Krishnam is all attractive. Mrityum, though he is a supreme lord, eternal, but for the sake of devotees, to give the pleasure to the devotees, now appeared the human body, but his body is still transcendental. That is interpretation of Sridhar Swami with authority on the commentary on Bhagavatam. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said that Sridhar Swami Maharaj commentary is the final authority. No one can write better commentary than Sridhar Swami Maharaj. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also refers to Sridhar Swami. So they made disappointed me. That's why what you should do? Yesham Sriya Vilaptanam Krishnenad Krishna Pitama Atmanam Dhanatu Sri Madhastambam Pashu Nayata Sanchayam. So these people, these Gopalas, cohort people, proud of the prosperity of these people has made them mad with pride, and their arrogance is backed up by Krishna. Now, instructing the clouds known as Samvartaka. There are many varieties of types of clouds. Then just like there are many varieties of the Vayu also, Marus also there, winds also many varieties, and many varieties of fire also, we just say Agni Agni, but there are 49 varieties of the fire also. Each performance, the particular performance, one should use the particular name of that fire for that puja. So similarly, here also different clouds are meant for different function. The Samvartak clouds are meant for inundating entire world at the time of annihilation. Before that, they are not brought into action. Only at the time of annihilation of this cosmic creation, they come and they discharge so much rain that entire world becomes melted into the water, like ocean, nothing else is seen. Those dangerous clouds, he summoned them, come. Ganam samvartakam nama megha nam chantakarinam Indra prachodayakruddho vakyam chahe samanyata. He called them, summoned them, and is speaking. What they should do? Esham siya vilaptanam. These people are proud of their opulences. Go and destroy. You rain, discharge so much rain that they are freed of all these opulences. Destroy them, cows and villages, crops, everything, nothing should be seen. Now go and remove their pride and bring their animals to destruction. Because of the proud. He thought that, Indra thought himself that is Ishara, controller. After that, what he do? Aham airavatam nama nagam aruhya nurvadevradam marudganair mahavegai nandagoshtajighamsaya. Nandagoshtajighamsaya. He is using the word again to destruction words. I will also come, not only you go first and discharge your rains and water and subdue all villages, all the entire world, and also I will also, mounting on my special elephant known as the Airavatam, I will also come in behind and will guide you to decimate the covered villages of Nanda Maharaj, Nanda Goshti. So saying, now Shukadeva Goswami said that ittam magata ajnapta megha nirukta bandhana nanda gopala masare pidaya masurudaka. Because of the instruction by Indra for the Samvata clause, there whatever bound by the rules that you should not rain before the cosmic annihilation. Now that they got order, they are discharging so much rain that they have started pouring the rain like a columns, not just like a small water. Rain and followed by, because already Indra said, I will come with the Maruts, Vayu Devata. So rain is coming, heavy wind is coming, thunder storm is there, hail storm is there, and because of that, all the living entity that started, Gopas and Gopis and the cows and calves all started feeling cold. Vijyotamana vidusbhi santaha sanayitmasi tevrai marudganayat Sri Trivray Marudganaya Nunna Vavrushur Jala Sarkara. Marudgana means it is the vayu, different of oil. It releases all the vayus also to help these clouds to rain heavily, which can destroy the entire Nandagam. Propelled by the fearsome wind gods, the clouds blazed with the lightning bolts, roared with the thunder as they hurled down the hailstorms. Sridhar Swami explained that the word Marudgana indicates the seven great winds, such as Avaha. There are different wind gods are there, different names are there. Okay? Who preside over the region of the Bhuvarloka and Pravaha, who hold the planets in their places. All the planets are holding in the, so many thousands of planets are there in the sky. So all this floating in the air, just like in our within our body, how many airs we have got? Five main airs and there five sub airs also there. The main airs, pranavayu, the life energy, then apanavayu, it takes down, udanavayu takes up, and samanavayu, jnanavayu. These are the one. Okay. Each vayu got the different function, each wind has got the different function. Similarly, there are all the different 47 or 45 different type of the vayus are the vayu devata. Each one has got different functions. So Sridhar Swami say that the pravaha vayu is responsible to keep all the planet system in its own place. Means this all the planet system are floating in the air. We can see every day. So as the clouds release the torrents of rain as thick as a massive columns, the earth was submerged in the flood and high ground could no longer be seen. At that time, all the cows were suffering. Achyasara ativatena pashavu jada vedana. Achyasara means too much rain. Ativatena, too much wind also. Rain is also there and wind also, too much wind. Just like a storm, you see. And all the cattle started suffering. People can run here and they take something to cover their head, but poor fellow, the cattle can't do anything. Gopa Gupta Sita Govindam Sharanam Yayo. Sira Santans, Sira Sutam Sakayena Prapachada Sarapidita Vepamana Bhagavata Padamula Mupayayo. And of course, what happened? Cows were also trembling with the cold, suffering the wind and cold and hailstorm also. They want to take care of the calves also, but they don't have anything. So they were protecting the calf with their body, and calves are just bending their head and they are all suffering. They came to take the shelter of the Supreme Lord. Padamulam, they want to take the shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord. And then, when they all come, then they all started praying. Krishna Krishna Mahabhagatan Natam Gokulam Prabhu Jatumarasi Devana Tratumarasi Devana Kupitad Bhakta Vachala. Hey Krishna Krishna, any difficulty in the Gokul, for the Gopalas and Gopis, they remember only Krishna. Any difficulty, any type of danger, all the time they remember Krishna Pahimam, protect me, nothing else. They know anyone except Krishna. So here also they come running because of they know that is only Krishna only can save us from this difficulty. No one can do because from the right from the childhood there have been so many difficulty, dangerous situations in Gokul and Nandagaon. But each and every time he protected them from all those dangerous situations. So all the gopas and gopis and cattle also, they know that only Krishna is the only ultimate shelter. No one can help from this torrential of the rains. Then they say, Mahabhaga, O great fortunate one, please deliver the cows from the wrath of Indra. So Gopas, they are not asking for that. Oh, please Lord, protect us. They are asking the Lord, protect the cows. So you can see how dear the cows for the gopas, in the, those rajavasis. It means here also we have to learn that in our houses also, when somebody is working, the duty of the household is to take care of the servants first. Used to be in the Vedic instruction there, in the household, when he eats the food, first he must give the food to the servants. Then he must go outside and ask, is there anybody hungry? But nowadays, if you go and ask, all the will come. But in Gandhi's used to be, first we have seen in the childhood, first give the servants the food, then they take mothers, before giving any food to anyone, they keep some rice or roti, whatever it is, whatever they cook, give to the cows first, and calves, then give to the servants, then one should, if there is somebody, beggar is there, coming, standing in front of the house, they must be given. Then they must feed to the children and old people, then after that elders. That is the system. So that's why now they are asking that, please protect the cows. They didn't say that, please protect us. But Krishna will protect, but if he say that, protect the cows, Krishna will protect the cows and us also automatically. From the, you are very affectionate to your devotees. Vatsha means it is calf. That's like a cow takes care of the calf, very great care. Similarly, Lord takes care of the devotees with great care. Lord will never ignore the devotees. Depending upon how much surrender we have to the Lord, in the same way Lord reciprocates. Ye athamam strapadyante tam tathaiva bhajamyam. It depends upon how much surrender we have it, Lord also reciprocates in the way. At the time of Lord Krishna's birth, Gargamuni predicted that he is like Narayan, he got all of his strength, he will protect all the Vrajavasis from any danger. So, now Lord said, then after having, the, when they come, Lord thought that, Krishna thinking himself, all of a sudden, it is not the season, in the Kartik month, this happened in the month of Kartik, rains not supposed to be there. Yesterday, Prabhu Mukundra Prabhu was telling that, it is the lakes are steady water. Though steady water, because there is no rain, all the rivers will have the clean and crystal clear water. When the rain is there, mud water will come up flowing. But there are no rains in the, this month, any river, any lake you go, all the water you find very clean and clear. So, Krishna thinks that it is not the season for the rains. Aparta ulbanam varsham ativatam silavayam swayage vihate swam indro nashaya varshati. It is not the season, but because I stopped the yajna for Indra swayage, and Indra became angry and called on that this rains unseasonal, which is not supposed to be now. Now, Lord, Indra is also devotees of the Lord. If the devotees perform some, commit any offense, Lord doesn't punish in the same way as you can punish to others. You want to rectify that fault. Instead of punishing, you want to rectify that so that the devotee is freed of his ego.
Tatra pratividham samyak atna yogena sadhaye loke shamanina mojyam hanishye srimadam tama. Tatra pratividham,
I must do some counteractive to counter this difficulty. I will completely counteract this disturbance caused by Indra, the demigods like Indra are proud of their srimad, hanishye srimadam. They are proud of their opulences. And out of foolishness, they falsely consider themselves to be Lord of the universe. They are not the Lord. They are the appointed directors in the management of the universe, nothing else. The Supreme Lord, Krishna can appoint anyone as Indra, he can dethrone him also. Okay, now you get out, I will appoint somebody. He can do, but Lord doesn't want to do it. He wants to maintain his order, okay? So, but Krishna, Lord, has that much capable power, he can do. By mystic power, I will completely counteract this disturbance caused by Indra. Demigods like Indra are proud of their opulence, and out of foolishness, they falsely consider that they are themselves the Lord of the universe, controller of the universe. I will now destroy such ignorance. Indra and all the demigods, they are the pure devotees of the Lord. Lord doesn't want just to punish them. Due to some ignorance, they get that proud. They take out that cause of their proud one day.
Nahi sad bhavitanam suranam ishvara isha vismaya matto asatam manabhanga prasamayo pakalpati.
Since the demigods are endowed with a mode of goodness, the false pride of considering oneself as the Lord should certainly not affect them. Even the demigods, sometimes they may feel that I am the God, they are not subject to reaction. That's like any government, president is there, ministers are there. Sometimes minister may take wrong decision. It doesn't mean that president will say, get out of this post. No. The wrong decision taken on his behalf, so he will rectify the situation. Similarly, the demigods, though sometimes they, because of the proud opulences, they think that they are controllers, Supreme Lord themselves, they come under that influence, Lord immediately doesn't punish them like he could punish to others, but he want to rectify the situation. That Lord says, when I break the false prestige of those bereft of the goodness, the purpose to bring them relief. So he does such activity so that they understand that they are not controllers, but they are servants of the Supreme Lord. They are there to do certain activity according to the laws of the nature as prescribed by the Supreme Lord. So demigods are supposed to be, in the purport written, sadbhava yukta, means endowed with a spiritual existence, since they are deputed servants of Supreme Lord. In the Brahma Bhagavad-gita also Lord says, Brahmarpanam Brahmahavir, Brahmagnav Brahmanavatam, Brahmaivatena Gantavyam, Brahma Karma Samadhina. That which is offered to Lord becomes spiritualized. The demigods engage in devotional service of the Lord by managing the various departments of cosmic manifestation, administration. So that is also service to the Lord, like temple president, the administrator. But it is service to the Lord. Somebody has to do it. On behalf of the Lord is appointed as administrator for the management. So in that process, sometime unknowingly, something may happen which doesn't please others. But doesn't mean that authorities will say, no, now you get out. Yes, it is. Something can happen. The day-to-day work, something will happen. But he is doing service, that is important. He is doing the service, so he wants to rectify the situation, what caused him to do this activity. Similarly, Lord also wants to rectify the situation, take out the proud which caused him the destruction of the Gokula. Instead of removing him from that position of Indra, he wants to rectify the situation, give a lesson. The purpose is that mana is a false prestige, manina. It's certainly anxiety-ridden burden for the conditioned soul. A falsely proud person is not truly affected or satisfied because his understanding himself is false and inflated. A person with on the false ego always subject to his causing disturbance to others. False ego is not good. Ego is there. Ego will not go anywhere. False ego is there. But when you come understand properly by performing devotional service, understanding that I am meant to serve the Lord, then we come to the properly swastha. It means we will properly situated. At that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that Divera Swarupohoi Krishnera Nitya Das. I am not the master controller, but I am eternal servant of the Lord. The six enemies, Arishadvarga, will remain automatically, not that I became pure devotee, the Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madamacharya gone away. No, they don't go anywhere, but they will be purified. The Kama, when it is purified, is the Prema. Krodha, anger will be there. That anger will be utilized in the service of the Lord. Somebody blasphemes the Lord, devotee will get anger and react very fiercely. Just like Hanuman, Srila Prabhupada has given the example. Hanuman, when Ravan blasphemed Ram, so he used the anger in service of Ram by burning Lanka. So anger can also be used in service of the Lord. Greediness is there in the purified state, the greediness in the contaminated state. I want to acquire everything like Hiranyaksha and Hirankashipu. No? But when the purified state, the greediness will be, just like in Bhakti Rasamsa said, what is the qualification for the progress of advancing the devotional service? Lalyam. One should have the greediness to serve more. Oh Prabhu, this Mataji is serving 3 days. I want to serve more 4 days. One should have the greediness to serve the Lord more and more. That will help us to advance in the devotional service. In the purified state, we will use that greediness in service of the Lord. Attachment is there. In the contaminated state, I have the attachment to my family and material thing. But in the purified state, I have the more attachment to the lotus feet of Radha Madan Mohan. Less attachment to my family and other things. Oh, family is there. Okay, they will be always be there. Each and every life when I get it, my family is there, my mother is there, my father is there, children are there. So it is not the special. But now I completed my responsibility to bring them up. Now I will take shelter of lotus feet of Radha Madan Mohan. I will serve it. So that attachment will go away. To the material things will go away. That is possible by hearing the pastimes of the Lord, serving the Lord. More we serve the Lord, that's why I said, while giving the definition of bhakti in the Bhakti Rasam Sindhu, Rupa Goswami said, what he said? Hrishikena Hrishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Richate. By serving the Lord, master, who is the master of the Lord, Hrishikesh, by serving by all senses, we got 15 senses. To bring it short, we can say, by serving the Lord of the senses, Hrishikesh, by serving Him by thought, word and deed, what will happen? When we serve the Lord by thought and word and deed, it becomes a bhakti, that is known as a bhakti. By such performance of devotional service, tat paratvena nirmalam. It will purify our senses. Tat paratvena. When all the senses are purified, then sarva upadhi vinirmuktam. There is no upadhi at all. It is, this is mine, that is mine, I am so and so, mama, mamiti. All upadhis come because contaminated senses. When the senses are purified in service of, by performing devotional life, there is no upadhi. Only then we will come to the being situated, we can transcend the pure mode of goodness to the pure mode of goodness. Shuddha Satyagun. Even living entity never can come to the Vishuddha Satyagun. Only Krishna will remain the Vishuddha Satyagun. Living entity can reach to the Shuddha Satyagun only. But to reach and stay on the Shuddha Satyagun also not easy, but possible. The easiest process is performing the devotional service, taking association, understanding the devotional service, hearing the pastimes of the Lord, and implementing teachings of that pastimes in our life. Yesterday we were talking, Srinvan Grunan Sam Trityanta Chintayan Namani Rupani Kamandalati. Hearing process has got, we must hear the pastimes of the Lord, remember it, contemplate them and apply those teachings in our life. Upadharayan, Nijadhyas. If you don't apply in our life, it will remain only story. Hey, I heard it, very nice story. This, it gives senses. But out of that story, what I got it? What I learned it? So the teachings must be applied. Then we get the perfect results of the devotional service. Just like 2 days before I referred from the 9th canto of the Bhagavatam, spoken by Sukadeva Goswami, Purusho Ramacharitam Sravanai Upadharyan Anusham Saparo Rajan Karma Bandhayar Vimuchyate. Sukadeva Goswami said that, but when you say Ramacharitam or Krishna Charitaman, the pastimes of the Lord, when you hear it, Sravanai, we should hear it, Upadharyan, we apply in our life. The teachings of the pastimes of the Lord must be applied in our life for change. By that process, Anusham Saparo Rajan, one will be freed from the creality. He will come to the, he will become a human being. For the human life, there is no place for the creality. In the 7th canto, 11th chapter, just 8 to 12, 5 verses, the Narada Maharshi explaining 30 qualities of human being. Srila Prabhupada gives this four verses heading qualification of human being. With anyone who thinks that I am a human being, they must possess those qualities. Their qualities are nothing but all the 26 qualities explained by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And also in the Bhagavatam also explained. So, in the life of the human being, there is no place for the creality. In the Rachasas, they have the place, creality. Creality. Human being not supposed to be cruel. That is meant for the Rakshasa demons only. So that Sukadeva Goswami say that by hearing the pastimes of the Lord, they will be free from the cruelty instinct. And by that, when you are not cruel, we don't commit any sinful activity. And we will be daily ourselves submitted to the lotus feet of the Lord, and karma bandhaya vimuchyate. One will be freed from the reaction of all karma. When you are freed from all reaction karma, means we are liberated. So that is how happens when we transform our life by hearing the pastimes of the Lord. Otherwise, it remains a katha.
Tasma sharanam goshtam mannatham matparigra gopaye svatmama yogena soyam me vrata ahita. Tasma sharanam goshtam, these people have taken, consider me mannatham, they have taken me everything for them. They have taken full shelter of me. Therefore, I must, by taking assistance of my Atmamaya, I must protect them because it is my vrat. I have taken a vow to protect my devotees. In Ramayana, wonderful explanation comes. When Vibhishan comes to take shelter of Lord Sriram, he says that, Sakala Deva Prapannaya Tavasmi iti yachate sarva abhyam sarva bhutebhyo dadami iti me vrataha. Sakala Deva Prapannayam, I am ignoring all the demigods. One takes shelter of me and they say that Tavasmi, I am yours. He says that I am yours. Do we say, my dear Lord, Radha Madan Mohan, you are mine, I am yours? How many times in a day we say it? Do we say, hey, Radha Madan Mohan is mine, not yours? Do we say? Each and every gopi used to say that Krishna is mine, not yours. When you say he is mine, like your son is there, say he is my son. Is it? Because you say that is my son, the relation. And you take things, oh no. So when you also say Radha is mine, Radha Madan Mohan, then the relation is there. Oh, Radha Madan Mohan ki jai. Okay. There is no relation, it is in a shanta bhava, neutral position. But if you say that I am yours and you are mine, reciprocation is there. When you say, Lord, I am yours and you are mine, so reciprocation always there. So that is, Lord say that, I am yours. When you say that, so I will take care of them. It is my vow that I will take, give shelter to them. No matter whether he is a what type of personality he is. When Vishnu come to take shelter, everybody was opposing. No, no, the brother to Ravan, how can you give shelter to him in the crucial time? We are about to engage in war. Now you should not give. That time, Lord
reveal that, no, it's my vow that even Ravan comes, I give shelter to him, to that extent he says. Even Ravan come and say that, I surrender to you, forgive me, I forgive me, I will forgive him, I give shelter. So that is what Lord is also saying, Vrata Ahita, it is my vow, that so that I will take it. In the 10th canto of the Bhagavatam, very wonderfully said, Brahma glorifying Krishna said that, Tathātate mādhavatāvaka kvacit drashyanti mārga tavi baddha saurudha. My dear Lord, those devotees say that tāvaka, I am yours. When the devotee says that, my dear Lord, I am yours, then because they become yours property, they are not afraid of any obstacle in their life. Drashyanti mārga tavi baddha saurudha. They will, without looking any difficulty in their life, they keep on moving. Taya Abhigupta Vitaranti Nirbhaya, because Abhigupta, they are protected. They know that they are protected by you. As such, in this material world, they will move on without any fear. Vinayaka Nipasu Murdhasu Prabhu. Even there is any difficulty in their life, still they are not afraid, because devotees think that, oh, I am put in this situation because Krishna wants me. And for my purification, Krishna is making me to suffer this difficulty, I will suffer it. Because it will give the pleasure to Krishna. Veda Ashlishava Padaratam Pinashtumam Adashanan Marmahatam Karotuva Yathatathava Vidhatu Lampato Mat Prananatastu Saivanapara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, my dear Lord, whether you embrace me, reject me, you are my worshipable Lord. That is completely Atmanishepa. In devotee's life, when you get the distress or happiness, one should not, oh, I got this one, I should not feel more happy. I got this trouble, I should not be morose. You should take that with the mercy of the Lord, Krishna it is. He knows what is good for me. He has given me this one. The happiness doesn't stay for long, it goes. Distress doesn't stay forever, it also goes. These all come and go. Why should I get disturbed with this one? My duty to serve the Lord. He will take care of me, because it is the promise that yoga chemam vahamyam. So that's why they are not disturbed. Lord Krishna also speaks the same, that I have taken a vow to protect them, I must protect them. Then, time up, that's why, okay. Ityukte nehaste na krutva govardhanachalam. So saying, Lord Krishna says that let us go to Govardhan. Because we worshipped Govardhan, Indra became angry. Now let us to Govardhan, ask for the shelter. The Vrajava said, how the Govardhan? Let us go and ask them. There is nothing wrong to pray the Lord, is it? The Lord appeared as a Govardhan, so let us pray the Lord. We want to sing, yesterday we were singing, same want to sing, but I see the time up. So all the Vrajavasis were closing their eyes, and meditating upon that Govardhan Lord, praying the Lord. In the meantime, Krishna, what he did? Ityukte denastena krutva govardhanachalam dadhara lilaya vishnu dadhara lilaya vishnu chhatra kamiva bhalaka. While speaking, and the Vrajavasis are meditating upon the Govardhan Lord, and he, with one hand, just lifted the Govardhan mountain. Just like a children can take out the mushrooms. Do they come in mushroom in here, Germany? Do they come? In the rainy season come up. After the rain, you find so many mushrooms. So to break or lift the mushroom, you don't need much strength. Even 3 months child can also just pluck it. In the same way, so easily, Krishna also lifted that big mountain, whose circumference, the circumference is 21 kilometers, and with one hand easily. Vishnu Chetrakamiva Balaka. Here, Lord, many places, Sukadeva Goswami used the word Vishnu for Krishna. So we have to be very little cautious not to differentiate with the Krishna and Vishnu.
Sometimes some devotees, I was taking the Bhakti Shastra class in Vrindavan, they say, but why you say that Vaishnava, why can't we say Krishna? We are devotees of Krishna, why we are called Vaishnavas? Why can't we call Krishnavas? I asked them, what is the difference between and Krishna? Oh, there is difference. Krishna and Vishnu different. No, no, never come under that illusion. Krishna is Vishnu and Vishnu is Krishna. Krishna is the source of all expansions. So, Sukadeva Goswami, many places in Bhagavatam, use the word Vishnu for Krishna. Here also using Lilaya Vishnu Chatragamiva Balaka. In the morning also His Grace Vikunda Prabhu was reading from the third chapter, the last verse. What will happen by hearing the glories of pastimes of Lord Krishna with the gopis, you shown the Phalasruti. There also Sukadeva Goswami used the word Vishnu. Vikriditam idam vadu idam cha Vishnu Chaddhanvita anusruniyadyata. Vishnu used the Vikriditam idam vadu Vishnu. So there also the Rasa Leela done by not Vishnu by Krishna, is it? Krishna is the one who played, who danced with the gopis. But Sukadeva Goswami used the word Vishnu. So we have to be a little cautious not to differentiate that he is big, he is small. It is an aparadha. So here also use the word. Then, Atha Bhagavan Gopan He Ambatata Pradaukasa Yathopa Josham Vishati Girigartam Sagodhana. He lifted Govardhan mountain. Vrajavasis, they don't accept it. The special Bharsana, and if you go there, hey, go, Krishna lifted. Say, no, no, Krishna didn't lift. It is Radharan who lifted it. They don't consider Krishna as. Said, oh, if you ask them, hey, why do you say Krishna lifted? No, no. If Krishna lifted Govardhan, you should have lifted with the right finger, right hand, is it? But Krishna lifted with the left hand finger. And the half portion, left part of the body of Krishna is Radharani. Radharani is always on the left hand side. If you say them, brother Barsana and this devotee, they all favor, always, they don't accept Krishna so powerful. They say that he lifted with the, why did he lift with the left hand? Because Radharani is on his left. So he lifted with left hand. Not Krishna lifted. Anyway, Bhagavatam, we know that Krishna lifted. But Krishna also accepts. He accepts that in the final event, all the gopas and say, we'll talk tomorrow, said, Vrajavasi, they sing this verse. Kachma kanko balbhayo kach gopan ke sahai Radha jo ki kripa se mai girvar liyo uthai. I got the strength by eating some, taking the butter, makan, and some that the gopas also, covered boys also helped me. But by the mercy of Radharani, I lifted the Govardhan mountain. He also accepts it. So Vrajavasi, they don't accept that Krishna lifted the Govardhan. Anyway, it is their pastime. There are few devotees of Radha and Krishna, the competition. When you say Krishna is Supreme Lord, Vrajava said, you may be Lord for you, Parawar is the village boy. They don't consider Lord Krishna as Supreme Lord. He's our home boy. Atha Bhagavan Gopan, hey Amba, hey Mata, hey mother and father, Tat means father, calling his mother and father, Yashoda and Nanda Baba, and all the Vrajavasi say, come, take shelter of under this Govardhan mountain, bring your bulls and cows and calves and all your paraphernalia, whatever there, don't worry that this mountain will fall down. They are all thinking that this little boy, I don't know how they lifted. Anytime it can fall down. That's why I said, don't be afraid of this one, it will fall down. Natrasa ihava karyo maddhastadri nipatanat maddhastad. Don't think that from hand this mountain will fall. No, don't worry. Varsha varsha bhayinalam tatanam vihatiswa. You come under this, take shelter under this one, mountain, Govardhan mountain, and get free from the distress you are getting due to this rain and wind. So, Krishna, why Lord has to do this pastime? Every pastime there is a reason. By the desire of Lord Krishna only, Indra come under illusion, did this one. In Vraj, gopis were able to meet the Lord. Gopas are also able to meet the Lord. And there were young gopis, manjaris, which called 10, 12 years gopis, because the social prohibition, young girls should not see at the boys. Nobody says they see the boys. Okay? They see and talk. But in the gone days, even when you are children in villages, it is prohibited. So young gopis wanted to be with Krishna, talk to Krishna, but because they are afraid of their elders. And Krishna, being super soul, he knows what is the desire of all the Vrajavasis. And Vrajavasis are his eternal servants, he is very dear to the Lord. So he wanted to bring them all together to give them opportunity, so that since all the Vrajavasis are all the time thinking of Krishna, they are purified, now he wants to give that blessing to be with them constantly, so that he can see his devotees and devotees can be with him. Even the Lord gives audience, like Dhruva Maharaj performed austerities, Lord Krishna came for how many hours? How many hours? Maybe few minutes, is it? After that, gone. Even yogis, they don't get opportunity to associate with the Lord for a long time. Just minutes, one. Minutes or hours. But here the greatness of the Vrajavasis, Gopas and Gopis, that Lord wanted to give his association for a long time. That is possible when they get out of their houses and come. So long as we are in the household affairs, we cannot get that attachment to the Lord, we cannot get the opportunity. Attachment, so many things were there, it will prohibit us. So Lord wants to make sure that they get out of their houses and come and take his blessing. So that he created a situation whereby all the gopas and gopis for 7 days and 7 nights were with Krishna. How much fortunate those people could be. For the 7 days, chud vyatha, chud trud vyatha sukha pekcham hitva tairva javasi bhi. For 7 days, Lord Krishna hold this mountain for 7 nights and 7 days. For these 7 days, Vrajavasi completely forgotten hunger, thirst and distress also. Not feeling, oh, I didn't sleep yesterday, I am suffering. There was no such feeling of distress for 7 nights and 7 days. And same with Krishna also, seeing all the devotees through the eyes, merging them into the ocean of his mercy. So all the Vrajavasis were happy to see Krishna face to face, including those young gopis who wanted to see because of the social restriction, prohibition, they couldn't see him face to face, but they all got opportunity to see the Lord face to face. Vichamanam dadara drim saptaham na chalat padat, for 7 days and 7 nights. Here, quoting from the Vishnu Puran, put it. Vrajaika vasibir harsha visvimitachi nirichitaha gopa gopi janai rastai priti visparik dechana. Lord Krishna held up the mountain while his praises were chanted by the residents of Vraja, all of whom now had the opportunity to dwell together with him, and who glanced at him with joyful and amazed eyes. Thus, the cowherd men and women were all elated, and out of loving affection, they opened their eyes wide. In the Pranayagita, when you read, Prabhuji is doing the Venugita, there are so many Gita, Pranayagita also, you can see how the gopis glorified the Lord that way. Oh, Krishna left our village, gone to the forest. So the gopis also, elder gopis also used to feel separation from Krishna. because the boy goes in the morning, comes in the only evening. Whole day they are separate. The gopas also used to feel separation from Krishna. They had so much attachment, attraction to Krishna, they don't want to be separated. But because of the activities, natural duties, they have to be separated. Krishna used to take calves. They were not taking the calves. If you read the Gopashtami time, in the comes, because he was just 5 years old, not yet come to the 10 years old, only after 10 years old only, then one can take the calves. Till that time, one should get practice to take the calves for grazing. So he was used to take the calves early in the morning, he comes in the evening, everyone was missing, they wanted to have, see Krishna, to be with Krishna, to talk to Krishna all the time. But Lord, he has given this opportunity to all of them. By continuously drinking the nectar of the beauty and sweetness of Krishna, the residents of Vrindavan felt no hunger, thirst or fatigue. And Lord Krishna, by seeing their beautiful forms, also forget about eating. The reciprocation is there. Drinking and sleeping. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur points out that 7 days of continuous rain from the Samvartak clouds failed to flood the district of Mathura because the Supreme Lord simply by the potency immediately dried up the water as it fell to the ground. Thus, Krishna's lifting of Govardhan Hill is full of fascinating details and has 4,000 years of remain one of his most famous pastimes. So, Acharya also accepted. In the Harivansha, quoting from the Harivansha also in the purports mentioned that, in the Harivansha mentioned that, the Krishna also says that, speaking to Krishna, say that this Govardhan not only protecting just the village, but it can give shelter to the entire universe, all the three lokas. Entire this universe, the Govardhan is capable of giving a shelter to the entire universe. What about this, after all this Vrindavan alone? So it is also mentioned that when Krishna lifted the Govardhan mountain, Govardhan came into ecstasy. Oh, Lord is touching my body. So Govardhan became out of ecstasy, he expanded so much that he given shelter to not one village, all the Chaurasi crores. Chaurasi means 84 multiplied by 20. How much is that? Multiply by 2. 168 miles area total. Okay? So he given the shelter to 168 mile area. As such, later we can see when Indra, after having seen that 7 days and seven nights, and as we drained so much water, but I don't see a single stone is falling down from the Govardhan mountain, he was surprised. He also saw that there is no water in any village. There is still dust. When the rain comes, there should be no dust. But you could see that all over the dust is there. He was surprised to see. So here in the Purportsila, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur also said that by Krishna, by using his mystic powers, dried up all the water.
Krishna Yoganubhavam Tam Nishan Indru Ativismitaha.
By seeing the yogic powers of Krishna, the mystic powers of Krishna, Indra was surprised, Vismitaha.
Nistambo Bhrashta Sankalpa.
He called on the Samvartaka clouds, stop it, no more rain. The clouds said, my dear Lord, no water left in the cup, we finished all. Whether even if they rain, still we don't have any water. We all completed, discharged. But Indra thought that, my Bhrashta Sankalpa, I want to destroy this Nanda Gokul, but my desire to destroy it is failed by the potency of Krishna.
Swan Meghan Samyavarayat,
understanding that I am failed in front of Krishna, you withdraw all the clouds.
Kam Chamyabhrum Uditadityam Vatavarsham Chadarunam Nishamyo Paratam Gopan Govardhanataro Brabid.
Having seen that when all the clouds withdrawn, the sky became clear,
everybody could see the sunlight, shining light, no wind at all. Krishna understood that Indra came to his senses. Now he called all the Brajavasis who were taking shelter under the Govardhan mountain. He said that now the time, don't worry, all of you can go back to your homes. Everything is there intact. Don't think that your house is for submerged, nothing. Your house, the property, everything is intact. Without any fear, go out of this mountain. And accordingly, all the Vrajavasis went out of the mountain. Niyatachatatrasam gopasastri dhanarbhaka uparatam vadavarsham viduprayastha ninnaga. Krishna said, my dear cowherd man, please go out with your wives, children and possessions. Give up your fear. The wind and rains have stopped. And the rivers, high water also subsided. All the Vrajavasis collected their paraphernalia and went out of the mountain. Then, because everybody has gone, then Lord has to bring back that mountain. Bhagavan apitam shailam sasthane purvapatrabhu pashyatam sarvabhutanam sapaya sapayama sadhilaya. And all the covered men and cows, all paraphernalia left the mountain, went out of the Govardhan mountain. The Lord Krishna, he brought down the mountain and kept in the place as it used to be. Without any difficulty, lilaya, just like a pastime. While all the creatures looked on, the Supreme Personality Godhead put down the hill in its original place as it was standing before. Who are the living entities seeing? Cows are seeing, Vrajavasis, Gopa Gopis are seeing, from the upper plant, demigods also watching it. Demigods know that Indra is out of ego doing, but they can't oppose the king. So they are all the demigods from starting from the Brahmaloka, everyone is watching them, watching the pastimes, what is happening.
Yashoda Rohini Nando Ramascha Balinam Vara Krishna Malinga Yudur Asheshasni Kataraha.
Yashoda and Rohini, mother of Balaram. Though because they have seen, every time Lord Krishna from childhood, you are displaying that I am not an ordinary person, I am the Supreme Lord. Many times he told the gopis, I am God. And gopis say, hey Kana, leave it. You always say that you are God. If you go there, if you happen to go to the Sheshasaya village there, the small lake is there, Kunda. The past time is the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also went there. And one day Krishna was there in that village with all the gopis, and while taking bath, Krishna said, I am Supreme Lord, Narayan. So all the gopis say, you always praise yourself. You are nothing, you are just your common bath. So they again say, no, I am God. Then, if you are God, finally some of the gopis said, okay, you always pushed yourself. If you are God, show me that you are a God. Immediately, Krishna transformed himself as a 400 from Lord Narayan. And Adishesh come, you are lying on that bed of the Ananta Adishesh. And immediately, Radharani, who was there, she transformed herself as a Lakshmi, started massaging in the feet of the Lord. All the gopis watching, they were become very, very happy. That pastime took place. They say that that lake is connected to the Chir Sagar in the Vaikuntha. It is also said that anybody taking bath in that lake will be liberated. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also took bath in that lake. That lake is there now, nicely cleaned and maintained, very nice. If you happen to go, you can go and take bath. It's wonderful.
What's the name of the lake?
Sheshasai. Name of the village. There in the temple, Lord is in the Sheshasai, sleeping on the bed of the Ananta Bhagavan. Name of the village, Sheshasai. The people are so generous that they give accommodation to all the devotees. We are 1500 to 1700 people, Parikrama. each how they accommodate it. Whatever the possible, even they may have this much place, they okay, come and sleep 200 people, no problem. They don't say, oh, we will be disturbed now. They will be waiting when the devotees come, we want to offer them place. That is the mood of the Vrajavasis. They feel happy to see the devotees. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also went there, and beautiful temple, beautiful lordships there. That is, you can see. And from the upper plant system, Divideva Gana Siddha Sajya Gandharva Karana Purpa Vashya Anipartiva. From the upper plant system, Gandharva, Charanas, Vidyadhara, Sajya, Siddha, they also started showering with the flowers and started dancing and singing and playing the music instruments. Shankadurdundava Nedir Divi Deva Prachodita Jagur Gandharvat Patayas Tumbur Pramukha Rupa. Tumbur Rishi also came to sing the glories of Krishna. All the living entities in the upper plant system are singing, dancing and playing. So, in the last he says that Tato Nuraktai Pashupai Parishrito Rajan Sagostam Sabalo Vrajadvari तथा विधान्यस्य कृतानि गोपिका गायन्तैर्मुदिता हृदि स्पृशा. Surrounded by his loving cohort boys and friends and Lord Balaram, Krishna then went off to the place where he had been tending his cows. So Krishna took it very easy. All other gopas were feeling something special to Krishna, the Supreme Lord. And from that moment, you see some photos where Lord Krishna lifted the Govardhan mountain. Also, you see some gopas holding the stick also. So there, the Vrajavasi said that Krishna when lifted, all the Vrajavasi thought, oh, this little boy lifting mountain, let us also help him. They took the sticks in the villages. They don't go outside. When they go out, there will be chadar on the shoulder, turban like Prabhu. And all the time, turban is there. Then they will have a stick. That is village life. So everyone has stick. They said, let us support him, help him. So they put the stick to support the mountain. They thought that we are also lifting the mountain. So when 3 days gone, 4 days gone, 5 days gone, 6 days, 7th day, all the Vrajas said, hey Kanaya, when we are tired, we can take the stick from right hand to left hand, still hold it. But you are holding since 7 days with your left hand finger, don't get so much trouble. Take some rest. Krishna said, can you hold this one without me? All the brothers say, hey, do you think that you are the one lifting? We all are there lifting. Okay? I lifted. When Krishna tried to take his finger a little down, all the sticks broke into pieces. Then immediately say, oh, keep it yourself. So then immediately Krishna smile, he knows everything. That is the mood of the Vrajavasi. Then they started thinking. Till now we are thinking that we all are lifting this mountain. But this one, even we took out all our sticks, still is holding mountain as it is. He there's so much strength in his finger. Because they are seeing the opulence of the Lord because of the effect of the Yoga Maya. They are not understand, still thinking that is one of us. Because Lord want like that, the Lord want to reciprocate and enjoy with his pure devotees, pastimes. Lord want to enjoy play. Otherwise, who can play with the Supreme Lord? Lord Narayan comes here, are you going to play? Hare Krishna. But Lord want to play. So that's why always Yogamaya is there to cover their intelligence, not to think that Supreme Lord, you are one of them. Okay. In the purport, before returning their homes, gopis shared intimate association with their lover, Sri Krishna, by exchanging secret glances. Ordinarily, they could not publicly talk about Krishna since they were chaste young girls in a religious place, village. But now they took advantage of this wonderful exhibition by the Lord and freely sang of his beautiful qualities. It's natural that a young man wants to do something wonderful in the presence of a beautiful young girl. The gopis were the most beautiful and pure-hearted young girls, and Sri Krishna performed the most wonderful activities in their presence. Thus, he entered the deep within their tender hearts, enlivening their eternal devotion to him. So, here in the purport also written, it is actually strong desire of this young gopis who were 10, 12 years and younger. Other gopis, they were always playing him, fighting. But these young girls could not, because they are not married. Before marriage, they are not supposed to talk to any boy. So that's why they are. But now this opportunity enabled them to talk to him. Now they can sing the glories of Krishna also. Nobody say, why you are singing? Say, no, he lifted Govardhan, which you could not do. He lifted, saved all of us. He saved our cows and calves. So we are singing. Village ladies, they are very good singers. They can make their own songs. In the morning also, Prabhu was telling that Vraja was still, now they sing in their Vraja Bhasha. Village ladies, folk songs, they make it, they sing it. They don't need any poetry, chandas and all these. So this, that is the this 25th chapter, where the lifting of Govardhan mountain. Yesterday we spoke about worshipping Govardhan, and today we have spoke about the lifting of the Govardhan. So how many days happened? First day after the Deepavali, they did the Govardhan puja. Second day Bhayadur. So third day Indra sent his clouds to destroy the village by pouring heavy rains for 7 days. How many days happened? 7 days. First, 192 days gone, 7 days, 9 days gone. Okay? Are you getting me? First day, Govardhan Puja. Second day, Bhayadur. Next 7 days, lifting of Govardhan. Indra was showering the rains. So 9 days gone. So on the 10th day, next day after Lord Krishna brought the Govardhan back as it used to be, on the next day, the 10th day, Indra, understanding the offender of the Lord, he came to ask for forgiveness with the 10 verses on the 10th of the day. So with the 10 wonderful philosophical verses, he glorified Lord Indra and asked Krishna and asked him for the forgiveness. We'll discuss tomorrow. Any question, comment, criticism, all welcome.
Approved. Clarification, did the
Power Boy
celebrate Diwali?
Heard
boy?
Did they celebrate Diwali?
Diwali?
Diwali, yeah, it is eternal festival.
And then
this festival going on long time. See, basically Diwali, we are giving religious importance also. Also the social, because by Diwali time, all the crops harvested, done, they come, grains come home. Season changing. Whenever their season changes, lot of bacteria comes up. So because of that one, all the villagers, they put so many lamps that will destroy the bacteria. And also in the villages, they make the big columns of the whatever it is, some they take the sesame seeds, plants, or devar, sorghum also, burn them, move around. The smoke goes all around, the bacteria is killed. That is scientific reason. All the crops have come, people want to celebrate I got the crops.
And Damodar Lila also took the place on
Diwali. That is also on Diwali. That is also Diwali.
Every year.
It is going on eternally, many, many years, not now.
On the same day, the Damodar Lila was
when he was 3 years, less than 3 years old. But all pastimes of the Lord, most of the pastimes took place in the Kartik. That's why it said that Kartik month one should go to Vrindavan. It is very important. If you want to advance in the devotional life, The going and staying in Vrindavan is very, very important. We get the special mercy of the Lord. The land Vrindavan itself is glory. And staying that time, it's something else. In case of ISKCON, you can see all proper disciples will come. All the devotees, most of them, they somehow see that they will come to Vrindavan. And if you go to our ISKCON temple, you can see how wonderfully Deepochava, Gopi Geet, Vasa. Gopi is always there helping all the devotees. Gopi Geet, if you hear it, I don't know whether you sing in Kartika or not, try to sing Gopi Geet. It's a very blissful it is. Very, when you sing every day, you get a lot of mercy of the Lord. Gopi Geet is very dear to the Lord and wonderful song. Anytime you can sing, but Kartik special. Kartik. You can sing every day. It's wonderful. You get the special mercy of. We'll sing last day. Okay, Prabhuji?
Yes, tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Okay, we can sing it.
Tomorrow is the last day and then the actual day of the...
Tomorrow is the last day?
Tomorrow, yes, Sunday.
Oh, I do two chapters. Then tomorrow I have to do faster. Two more chapters left. I was thinking 4 days, okay. Okay. Okay, tomorrow we can do. Can you make copies or put it there? I don't know.
Yeah.
Gopi Geet.
Yeah.
Do you have? Otherwise I can give it.
I can find out. Yeah.
Maharaj, how means material ocean of existence?
I didn't get it.
Half sagar. That is the material world.
Material. Bhava means birth and death. In the material world is the cause of this creation. In the whole universe, out of this universe, Lord Krishna is the cause of the creation. But within this material world, the Shiva Parvati is the cause of creation. That's why we say Jagannatha, Jagatpita. So Shiva says, he is the cause of creation, not Krishna. They don't understand that Krishna is the cause of Lord Shiva. See, that understand the Shiva and all this, the Brahma Samhita wonderfully explained it. What is the meaning of Shiva and Shivaling and all this? Nicely explained it. Brahma Samhita also. Okay, any other question, please? Prabhu.
Yeah. They
are not transcendence. Raksha Bandhan not started in the historical. It is historical place. Took place. It used to be, but there is no spiritual identity for that one. Raksha Bandhan. But we take it on the day of Raksha Bandhan day, devotees tie that Raksha Bandhan to the hands of Balaram. Do they do? In Borsan also we got Krishna Balaram. All the people, devotee, non-devotee, they come and tie so that Balaram will protect it. So devotee feeling, okay, whatever you fail, Lord is ready to accept it. But it doesn't have any spiritual significance for that. It is sociological, it is, basically. Brother will protect the sister. Whether you tie the knot or not, brother has to protect the sister. Elder brother must be treated like a father. Elder brother must be given respect and treated like you would respect your father. Elder sister must be respected like a mother. That is scriptural injunction. Younger sister must be treated like your own daughter. That's scriptural injunction. So, whether younger daughter or elder sister, you will protect. You will protect your mother.
Your brother should not be like a Ravana.
Ravana was a good brother. No. Ravana was a good brother. See, Ravana never did anything wrong to his family and its citizens. You show anyway. If you tell that Ravana was bad, Silonis will fight with you. In Dorsana, we are burning the effigy of Ravana. I used to go to Silonis, prayers, everything. Say, why you are doing burning? He was a very good king for us. He has given all facilities to his citizens. You ask any Siloni, they don't accept that Ravana was a bad person. And even Tamil Nadu, they said, no, no, it is not nothing like that. They know Ravana, no Ramsi, he never kidnapped Sita. This is a fight between the Vaishnavas and Shivas. Tamil Nadu people, educated class, even now they say like that. It is a fight between Vaishnavas. Because in Kanchipuram, there are two Kanchi, Vishnu Kanchi and Shiva Kanchi. And kings all, only on the bank of the Kaveri, always they used to fight. Fighting is there. Okay. But the Rachabandhan has no spiritual significance. Okay, we can take blessings of Balaram and okay. That. Yeah, so Lord is whatever the way you act, serve the Lord, he reciprocates. He's always there. He's there always to protect the devotees. Even if you don't tie the Rachabandhan, still he's there to protect the devotees. Can you stop it here? Srimad Bhava Prana ki jai, Govardhan Lila ki jai, Giriwar Govardhan ki dhar ki jai, Lapraapad ki jai.